Hi, I'm Jim Covington. Today is Thursday, January 29th, 2015. I'd like to welcome you to this week's issue of ISBA Statehouse Review. The General Assembly has started introducing bills, and I think we'll start committee action probably in about 2 weeks. A lot of bills that will be introduced will never end up being passed to the governor, but you never know, so we'll just go through the first six that I have picked out that you may have some interest in. The first is House Bill 298, introduced by Representative Ron Sandeck from Lombard, and it amends the Municipal Code to allow municipalities to declare bankruptcy under federal law. That was just introduced and referred to the House Rules Committee. The second bill I'd like to talk to you about is House Bill 303 that amends the FOIA Act. It's introduced by Representative Margot, and I hope I pronounced her name right, McDermid. I hope I got that right. And it prohibits a public body from restricting access to a severance agreement that is funded in whole or part by public monies or releases a claim against a public body. It prohibits a public body from requiring imposing any condition on any party to keep allegations, evidence, settlement, amounts, or any other information confidential, except when it's necessary to protect a trade secret, proprietary information, or information that is otherwise exempt on the FOIA Act. It grandfathers in all pending agreements that make that information confidential. That's just been introduced and sent to the House Rules Committee. The third bill is House Bill 304, introduced by Representative Dan Brady from Normal, and amends the Clerks of the Courts Act to allow the circuit court clerk to reasonably rely on the notice of a party's change of address received by the United States Postal Service as a true and correct statement of the party's current residential address. And it applies to any notification required by law to be made by the circuit clerk to a party. It was just introduced and referred to House Rules Committee. The third bill is House Bill 340, introduced by Representative Barbara Wheeler from Crystal Lake, and it amends the Illinois Vehicle Code to require a minimum term of imprisonment of 10 consecutive days if a person is convicted of driving on a revoked or suspended license for driving under the influence or a statutory summary suspension if there is any amount of alcohol or illegal drug in his or her breath, blood, or urine. That's just been introduced and referred to the House Rules Committee. The fifth bill is Senate Bill 90, introduced by Senator Ira Silverstein of Chicago, and it creates a rebuttable presumption that a will is void if it was executed or modified after the testator has been adjudicated disabled and the will was executed or modified without court approval. The presumption may be overcome by clear and convincing evidence that the testator had the capacity to execute the will or codicil at the time it was executed. That's just been introduced and referred to the Committee on Assignments in the Senate. The sixth and final bill is Senate Bill 86, introduced by Senator Pam Althoff from McHenry, and amends the county's code to allow state's attorneys to pursue defaulted fines or penalties or installments of those to be collected by any means authorized for the collection of monetary judgments. It specifically authorizes state's attorneys to retain attorneys and private collection agencies to do these collections, and any of those collection agencies or attorneys, their fees will be charged and added on to the defendant or offender. And that's just been introduced and referred to the Senate Committee on Assignments. Thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you next week.